What's up, everybody? Welcome to Money Management Channel. My name is Andrei, and today I'm going to be doing analysis on GNUS stock. First of all, brief information about this company. GNUS Brand International Incorporated is a leading global kids media company developing, producing, marketing, and licensing branded children's entertainment properties and consumer products for media and retail distribution. The company's new cartoon channel is available in over 100 million US television households via a broad range of distribution platforms, including Comcast, Cox, Dish, Amazon Prime, Sling TV, Apple TV, Roku, Amazon Fire, and more. And let me show you their financials. For now, their total market cap is $697.83 million. They have a revenue of $1.92 million with a net income of negative $393.3 million. They have total cash of $50.46 million with total debt of $4.12 million. And their current ratio is very good, it is 7.85. And let me remind you that everything that is above 1.5 is a good and very good current ratio. Let's continue with their website and let me show you their press release section. So, we have several recent news from March the 4th till March 16th, and I want to pay your attention on just three recent news. Here is the first one. It was published on March the 4th, and it is a CEO newsletter, and as you can see, that Marvel Studios GNUS Brands announcement to be March 30th, and it will be, in my opinion, it will be the major news for this company, and it might be a major catalyst for the price of this stock, because after this partnership with the Disney's Marvel, they will have more licensed products for their shows, and they will open Marvel show as well for this, for superheroes, and they can add their merchandise, and this will increase their revenue and their profits. And let me quote you this paragraph. As a final note, people continue to ask when we will officially announce our news with Marvel that has previously been referenced. Were it up to us, it would have been announced long ago. But we do not set Marvel's press schedule. They do. I'm happy to report they have advised us that we can announce our deal with them no later than the end of March, and we will. I should also add there have been other rumors regarding people and properties GNUS Brands is working on and with. Needless to say, we cannot announce anything regarding people, properties or deals unless and until an agreement is concluded. When such agreement occurs, and we are able, our shareholders can rest assured that we will announce it swiftly. Exciting things are afoot at GNUS Brands. We have a very strong balance sheet. The company has zero debt and a substantial amount of cash on hand. We are looking at a number of important and highly accretive acquisition targets. And in my opinion, after this announcement that will take place on March the 30th, as you can see here, we might see much more news with the partnerships of this company, because they have enough money to make some partnership, they have enough money to make some acquisitions, and they will do it. And I think with the improvement of their balance sheet, we have to wait until they will release their next earnings report. And according to Nasdaq data, as you can see, it might be announced on March 29, 2021. And this data is derived from an algorithm based on a company's historical reporting dates. So we don't have for now information where will be their report, but we can assume that it will be at the end of March, and I think it might be the same day as the announcement with the Marvel Studio. And here is institutional investors of this company, and as you can see, we have several fillings on 13D/G section. And only one recent filling was made that this company, Anson Funds, closed their position. CVI Investments, let me show it to you, they increased their position of more than 80%. And across 13F reports, you can see that just one company closed their position on March the 8th. And let me show you the amount of their shares. They have $178,000 in value. And as you can see, Vanguard have more than $4.5 million in this company. And their share is increased by more than 25%. And I think all in all, it is a good sign for the company that institutional investors, they are buying these shares. And before we dive deep into the technical analysis, please subscribe to my channel with notification bell. In this case, you won't miss my next video. And hit the like button. It helps me a lot. So we have a little bit weird structure right here. And it's rather difficult to make Elliott wave breakdown for now, but we can make this channel, and the price respects this channel very well. And as you can see, we strictly go to the upside, and the lowest border of this channel is the strong support, as you can see, and it might hold as a new trend, and it might hold with the help of 55 exponential moving average. And if we will have some negative news in the upcoming days or weeks, we might see some decline in price, and we might break this lower position. And in this channel, your potential entry points as an investor will be along these levels of Fibonacci retracement tool. So 0.382, 0.5 and 0.65, these three levels are the most important for this price action for now. And let me show you some resistances. On a daily chart, we can see clear resistance on 3.04 level. And let me mark it for you. Here is the first one. And here we can see second one at around $4 mark. And these are the most closest resistances for now. And we have to wait until the earnings report will be revealed. And this will give us more information in order what to do with this asset. As you can see, we have a good volume each and every time on a green candle. And this also might indicate that we are on bullish territory. And we might have some fluctuation during next, I think, week or so. And then we might go to the upside. And I think for now that's it. If you like my video, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done this before. And see you guys and girls next time. Bye!